Asibingelele bazalwane, asibingelele, asibingelele igameni lika Jesu Kristu wase Nazaretha. Happy Sunday, happy Holy Sunday. Sithembe abazalwane bayaphila, sithembe ukuthi bakhonze kahle. Namhlanje usuku olukhulu, usuku lokukhonza. It's Revelation Time Show. You all know ukuthi Sundays evening they all belong to Revelation Time Show with your boy Brother Ncewu. It's where we teach and preach the word of God. It's all about Jesus Christ and him alone, him crucified. Sesibuyile-ke bafethu, isikhathi 7:08 PM kusihlwa, sibiza wonke umuntu sisakasondele. You know the vibe, you know the grill. Please do share the live and mention people. Kunabantu ade besebenza namhlanje, kunabantu ade bebhizi namhlanje abatholanga ithuba lokuya esontweni, and I'm one of them today. So sondelani bafethu, sondelani. Ngiyabona ukuthi ngiphethe indoda enkulu laphana, udokotela wokuchwechwa siphethe laphana, unyambozo siphethe, udingiswayo siphethe, indoda enkulu laphana namhlanje on our show. So I'm super excited namhlanje bafethu, njengoba nibona kubhaliwe on your screens ukuthi namhlanje i-topic izobe ithi Kingdom Agents. Sondelani-ke bafethu, sodla izwi kaNkulunkulu namhlanje. Sondelani, sondelani. Mase nenze njalo-ke, nishare live and mention people. I'm just gonna give my brother ithuba lokuthi nje asibingelele, azi-introduce kuthina, and then-ke mase-ke nani ngiphinde ngiyabuya nibingelela, and then mase siyaqala uhlelo lwethu namhlanje. Nyambozo fethu, awusibingelele my brother, introduce yourself to our people and then ubingelele ama-viewers ethu.
Greetings, 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 saints, in the name of Jesus. As my brother has said, I'm here to just share the word of God under the title of Kingdom Agent. So we're just going to share the word, and then we believe God is going to do something and transform us and bring us into the state of maturity. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Siyabonga ndoda enkulu, siyabonga, siyabonga kakhulu. Bafethu, njengoba seshilo uNjabulo wakamthethwa, sondelani bazalwane, sondelani, sondelani, and mention people, press the share button. Man of God, without waste of any time, Petu, just take the platform and then take us through to i-message uNkulunkulu ayibeke enhlizweni yakho namhlanje. Sifuna ukulalela, simehlo manye la sizwe. Simngento sifuna ukuzwa izwi likaNkulunkulu. So take the platform my brother, sizwe izwi likaNkulunkulu.
Okay, once again greetings bafowethu egameni lika Jesu Kristu wase Nazaretha. So before we start the reading of the word, I'm just gonna pray and then we're gonna read the scriptures and then try to dissect the topic that is given unto us. So we're just going to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we submit ourselves before you, as we are here, Lord, we pray that you begin to reveal your mystery. Your mystery is about the kingdom, so that you may begin to know the purposes and the aims that you have about our lives. Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, siyathandaza egameni lika Jesu Kristu wase Nazareth ebusuku, Nkulunkulu wethu, that you advance your kingdom, Father, that you begin, Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, egameni lika Jesu, to change our mindsets towards your kingdom, Nkulunkulu, and shift it, Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, egameni lika Jesu, and be based on you alone, oh Father. In the name of Jesus, we pray and we ask you, Daddy, in the name of Jesus, that you begin to transform us and change us, Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, and add, Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, to our perspective of the kingdom. We pray, Nkulunkulu, egameni lika Jesu Kristu wase Nazaretha, egameni lika Jesu Kristu, we trust in you alone, oh Father, and we pray and we thank you, Father, ukuba uzokwenza umsebenzi egameni lika Kristu uJesu wase Nazaretha. Amen. So just nje bafowethu, we are given a topic under a kingdom agent. So this is one of the burdens uNkulunkulu nje that is bekade ngihlupha ngaso in these days, because we know very well ukuthi we are saved, and when we are saved, we are brought into something that is called a kingdom. So now uNkulunkulu ke esisindisa usisindisa ngepurpose ethile. So I'm just gonna quickly just draw the basic foundation under this topic, because we, as you can see, ukuthi we have something which is the kingdom, and then there's something that is an agent. So kingdom agent. So we've got kingdom agent. So we know very well, ukuthi the kingdom that we are speaking about, it's the kingdom of God. It's the kingdom of our dear God, the one that we believe in. So when we speak about the agent, in definition, igama nje elithi agent likhuluma about somebody who can stand on behalf of another. So, which simply means when we conjugate these two names, it gives us this thing which is called kingdom agents. So, we are kingdom. So, we are standing in place of another. In other words, we are representing something. So when we speak about the kingdom then, which simply means we are those who are representing the kingdom of God. So when we give this title a definition, which means we are simply speaking about people who are representing a certain kingdom. So whatsoever that they do, labasendwe khona to represent that kingdom, they do according to the criteria of that kingdom, which is the kingdom of God. So basically in Jabafoetu, that's the description or an introduction to our topic, which is kingdom agents. So we know very well what we are, people who are saved. When we are saved, we are then given something to do. We are given the assignment to do in this kingdom. So we're just gonna go quickly straight Bafoetu in the book of Colossians, chapter number 1, verse number 13. So I'm just gonna go over my Bible here. The book of Colossians, chapter number 1, verse number 13 and 14. So it's just gonna give us a description. Let's start with verse number 12. It says, give thanks unto the Father, which had made us meet the partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who had delivered us from the power of darkness and had translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. So he has delivered us from the power of darkness, and then he translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. So there is the basic foundation, which we have been delivered from the darkness, and then we are brought into the kingdom of his dear Son. So when we are brought into the kingdom, it's not just only ukuthi we are saved and then it ends there. Because uNkulunkulu, when you look at the book of Genesis, we will find out ukuthi uNkulunkulu, when he created man, he created a man for a particular purpose. Reading Genesis chapter number 1, verse number 26, you will find out ukuthi uNkulunkulu, he displays the purpose ukuthi let us create man in our after our likeness. So that means that likeness is to be like God. So let us create man in our image after our likeness. And then he goes on to say, let them have dominion over the earth. So you see the aspect of dominion there in the Garden of Eden. So that's the kingdom. You see, there's the purpose uNkulunkulu abenikeza, or he was delegating his purpose about a man. So what happened then? A man fell. So now when Jesus came, he came to extract us, to extract us from that darkness, because ngesikhathi umuntu ewa wanikeza authority to his enemy. So now Jesus esibuyisileke manje into his kingdom. Mayisibuyisa kule kingdom now, usesibuyisa, usinikeza certain things then now. So, and then we're going to go to Matthew chapter 9, verse number 37. There is something that I want us to look at. Lapha ku Matthew chapter number 9, verse number 37. So it's going to give us a glimpse ukuthi uNkulunkulu, how does he looks at people who are lost. So, but when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. And then 37, he said unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenty, but the laborers are few. So this is one of the things. The harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. So which displays unto us, he needs laborers in his kingdom. He needs people so that they may go and do something for him, so that they may harvest for him, because the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. So as we embark then on this topic, we are going to look into the characteristics or things that are important for somebody who is a kingdom agent to walk in. Because now we understand ukuthi Jesu is giving ama disciples wakhe. Because number one, the first thing you need to know, he was moved with compassion. And then when he was moved with compassion, so he then told them this statement, ukuthi laborers are few, the harvest is plenty. So Jesus needs laborers. He needs laborers to labor for him, to do something for him, because this is a kingdom. So one of the things in this kingdom is to draw people, because when God restored us, he restored us in order to send us out so that you might bring people into his kingdom. So the first parameter that we're going to look, number one, it is faith. It is faith. The first parameter is faith. And then we're going to look at Hebrews chapter number 11, verse number 6. So lapha, the Bible says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. And we know very well as we read the scriptures, that introduces us into this kingdom, it is faith. So we are saved by faith. So when we are saved by faith, it allows us to be the children of God. So we become the children of God by having faith. We are saved by faith. We become the children of God. And then from there, we journey, because it's not only about what we are introducing to this salvation only. So, and then, go 2 Corinthians chapter number 5, verse number 7, it says, for we live by faith, not by sight. So this is a parameter that is important for somebody who is a kingdom agent, or who is an agent of the kingdom. Because for that person to be able to advance what God wants to do on the earth, as a man is placed on earth to advance the kingdom of God. So for that person to advance the kingdom of God, kudingakala ukuthi lo muntu abe ne faith kuNkulunkulu, because you can't operate in this realm without faith. You need faith, because the realities of this world angeke zize nje kalula in terms of ukuthi kuzoba easy yonke into. But if faith allows us to dive deep into the realm of God, into the frequencies of God, to dive deep, we level la uNkulunkulu akwazi ukuthi a operate noma asebenze ngathi. So he needs us to have faith. So the just shall live by faith. Lapha ku Romans chapter number 1, verse number 17, it says the just shall live by faith. So the just, what is the just? The just is the one that has been saved through faith. So that person who is just will live by faith. So you now understand ukuthi faith is not only for ukuthi introduce into this salvation or into this kingdom, but also it's for living. Because while we are living, there will be circumstances that will need us to have faith. So as the ones who are sent, as kingdom agents, we need to operate by faith. So that's the first parameter that we are looking at with regards to umuntu, who is a kingdom agent, or who is an agent of God, who a person who is showing a kingdom, because this is not only by speaking, but it's a living. So they just shall live by faith. And then we're going to go on again to the second parameter that we're going to look at, which is parameter number two, which is the kingdom mindset. So we need to understand, which as we are in the kingdom, we need to have a certain mindset, because you know that the world is injecting us with certain things. It's injecting us with a certain mindset, which isn't ozenzeka kanje. But since we have been born again, since we've been called into this mountain, since we've been called into this kingdom, we need to have the mindset of the kingdom. We need to understand, which as a person who is the agent of the kingdom, how do I think? Ngibuka kanjani into? So then we're going to look Colossians chapter number 3, verse number 1. Sizoqala khona nje lapha Colossians chapter number 3, verse number 1. So it says, if ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. And then verse number 2, it says, set your affection on things above, not on things on earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. So verse number 2, set your affection. Another translation, it says, set your minds on things above, which means the thing, Tina, manje sibhekile manje, we are not just looking on earthly things, but we are looking on things above, because the understander Uguti, we are people who are born again, we are people who are brought into the kingdom. So it's a kingdom in a system, a operator guyo. It's not just a random thing, but kunama systems, a kingdom, a operator guyo. So that is why we have to reset our mindset. So we reset our mindset, we look on things that are above, the things of heaven, the things of the kingdom. So we reset our mindset according to the values of the kingdom, because the values of the kingdom, ziyasikhombisa bazalwane ukuthi awafani amavelu kingdom namavelu omhlaba. Because one of the things, when you read to Matthew chapter 4, 5, 6, 7, uzodiscover ukuthi indlela uJesu abeshumela ngayo, uJesu ebetheacher ngayo entabeni, uzivezela ukuthi it's not just a normal thing, whereby he teaches you to live according to the standard of God, because you live in forgiveness, you live, which when you do things, you do them secretly. Yeah, so those things are not like the standard of the world. And you see what is we do things for ourselves. But that's not the mindset or the way a kingdom is organizing. But the mindset of the kingdom, it makes us to focus on God. It makes us, it's God first before any other thing or me. So we look, in mindset, it shifts towards the kingdom, because we understand what by shifting in mindset to izinto zombuso, we send a local, sikwazi ukuoperator kwi level uNkulunkulu asidinga ukuthi sioperate kuyo, because izinto indlela uNkulunkulu azenza ngazo azifani nendlela abantu abenza ngazo. So that the first thing that we need to know. Say Matthew chapter number 6, verse number 33. It seek first the kingdom of God, and then all these things shall be added unto you. Then when you read, you will find out ukuthi uyakhuluma uJesu is speaking about izinto ezipertaina ukudla, ugqoka, and everything ezingama need to his disciples. But now he says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and then all these things shall be added unto you. Uyabona ukuthi now I-mindset yethu seyishintshiwe manje ekuthenini sifuna izinto, but manje sifuna uNkulunkulu. So ngokufuna kwethu uNkulunkulu, these things will be added unto us, because that's how actually the kingdom operates, because a kingdom it operates on the premises yokuthi uNkulunkulu ungubani, on the premises ukuthi uNkulunkulu wenzeni, because he has done something. He has done something so big ngokuthi ascend uJesus to the cross. So by that we know and we understand that our lives have been redeemed, and then uNkulunkulu he will be able to add things, because we remember ukuthi ensimini yase Eden before a fall umuntu ubengabhekile izinto kakhulu, he was there just to govern, but ivalue yakhe was not defined based on the things ezingama gains. But ivalue yakhe beyidefinwa ukuthi urelate kanjani noNkulunkulu and where he comes from. So when we come into the kingdom, our mindset mele ishifte towards ukuthi we look unto God. We seek the kingdom first. Before we do, the kingdom comes first. That the mindset of somebody who is an agent of God. So that's the thing. And then we go on. There are many things of which I'm not going to be able to finish these things that I have to touch, but these are some of the things that I've took so that we can discuss and share the word of God about this. So we're going to go on to the third parameter we're going to look, which is the ambassadors of Christ. Ambassadors of Christ. So when we look at that, when you read 2 Corinthians chapter number 5 verse number 20, so uPaul laphana uyakhuluma uthi therefore we are ambassadors of Christ. So let us just go straight to it so that we may read it. 2 Corinthians chapter number 5 verse number 20. So uPaul mayibhala, he speak about the authority in the form of ambassadorship. So now then we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God. So he speak about being an ambassador, and when you study about the ambassador, you will understand ukuthi ambassador ayiwarisheki ngezinto zayo, kodwa iwarisheka ngezinto zalapho esendwe khona. Because for you to be an ambassador, you have to be sent by a certain nation, you have to be sent by a certain country in order for you to be an ambassador. So lokho kusitshela ukuthi as an ambassador, we do not worry about our own things, but we worry about the things of the kingdom. So this makes us to be able to understand ukuthi in this life we're not just walking alone, but we are walking having witnesses of heaven, having God on our side. So whatsoever that we do with the consciousness ukuthi we are ambassadors of God. So whatsoever that we do, we are ambassadors of God. And then we go to Ephesians 6, which speak about the very same thing. Verse number 19. So, and Paul, he says, and for me, verse number 18. So praying always with all prayer and supplication in the spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints, and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known of the mysteries of the gospel. Then verse number 20, for which I am an ambassador in bonds. So the other version, for which I'm an ambassador in prison for. So Paul was bound in prison, but now he says to this church, he's an ambassador of the gospel of Christ. So as an ambassador, one of the things you worry about the gospel. Paul was in prison, but now he's worried about the things of the gospel. So he's not worried about this condition because he understands the mandatory purposes. Even Nila, it's because of this gospel. It's for me to advance this gospel of Christ. As I'm here in this prison, I'm here to advance the kingdom of God. So that's the mindset. That's the parameter of being an ambassador. An ambassador does not worry about his own things, but he worries about the things of God. Because as he worries about the things of God, he comes and he shows up with intensity thing. So that is why we find that through Paul, God was sending men to help him in his ministry, to help him as in any need. Because now Paul was worrying about the things of God, even though he had this business, but uNkulunkulu was taking care of him about the kingdom. So, and one of the things we need to know about the ambassador is that wherever he goes, uNkulunkulu, he is with him. uNkulunkulu is with him. And the ambassador is someone who comes. When he is an ambassador, he comes and represents God in the spaces of influence. Because we need to understand that in this world, in order for us to have influence, we need to touch deeply in God and understand ukuthi singobani and be conscious ukuthi singobani kuNkulunkulu, so that we can operate ngokwendlela uNkulunkulu afuna si operate ngayo in this world. Because that's the thing we need to understand, ukuthi we ascend here. I'm not a doctor, but I'm not a doctor nje kuphela, but before I'm a doctor, I'm a servant who is sent there into the hospitals. I'm sent there kulama practices. I'm sent to represent God. That is why ngihamba ngine confidence, not only in my ability in my abilities, but in God, because I understand ukuthi ngifakwe lana because I am sent. That is why if we understand and we have that consciousness, we'll be able to understand that they will happen to us, and we're not gonna compromise, because we understand we are ambassadors and impilo wethu is taken care of by God. So when we understand that, kuzosenza lokho siphile in peace, even if things are not happening ngendlela thina as expect ukuthi zenzeke ngawo, because we have been brought to a consciousness ukuthi we are ambassadors and our lives are being taken care of by God. So when we have that mindset, si understand ukuthi noma ngabe kuphi la uNkulunkulu asithuma khona in the spaces of influence, because God needs people in the spaces of influence. Kuma industry esikuwo uNkulunkulu udinga ama ambassador. Wherever we are, uNkulunkulu udinga ama ambassadors who will stand for him, who will speak his truth and not compromise. Because for example, if you can look at the politics here, we are having people who are compromising. But if we had ama ambassadors lapha in those spaces, people who will stand for the truth of God and not compromise and say no, ngisho ngathiwa ngiyaxosha, because lo muntu usuke se understand ukuthi uyi ambassador, ngisho ngathiwa bamxosha just because akavumanga ukukompromisa, uya understand ukuthi kuvela kuye uNkulunkulu konke okusempilweni yakhe. So that's the mindset or the knowledge or the consciousness that you might be brought into for us to operate and have the influence and the impact kule generation yethu. Because we are in a cruel world. So for us to be able to conquer the world, we need to stand for the truth of God. We need to stand and be conscious ukuthi singobani kuNkulunkulu. When we know that, we will be able to have peace that surpasses all understanding. So we are ambassadors, and the jealousy of God is invested in those who are ambassadors. So God is taking care of those people because they are ambassadors. Remember, we are speaking about people who are agents of God. So people who are sent, who are standing for God. So in the spaces of influence, we are standing for God. We proclaim the truth, no mangatua in the way going, but because we are brought to a sonship, which then allows us to operate as ambassadors. So that's the thing. So we go on to parameter number four, which is Russia's living, which is characterized by a Christ-like character. So when you look at Philippians 2, verse number 14, sizothola umongo of what this says. So verse number 14, he says, do all things without murmuring and disputing, that you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation. Among them, you shine as light in the world. So this Bible says we stand blameless and harmless. So, which means in our conduct, we must be blameless. Wherever we are, we must not be found with something that is of blame. Somebody is like this, has done this. So how we conduct ourselves, it allows us to be able to represent God. How we conduct ourselves, how we do. So he's saying, do these things that you may be found blameless. And then in the midst of this crooked and perverse way, we know so in order for us to overcome this world, we must not walk ngendlela yalelizwe, because this is a perverse world. So this allows us to be able to live this according to the standard of God, to live out the character of Christ, to live out the ways of God, to live according to the character of Christ, because Jesus, he is a clear picture or a demonstration of how must we live. In other words, impilo yethu kumele is pointed towards ukuthi uJesu uphile kanjani when he was on this earth, because he is a good example of ours as believers. He is a good example of ours. So okusho ukuthi we look empilweni kaJesu, then we live ngendlela uJesu aphile ngayo. In other words, we have to reach to a level whereby before even I respond to someone, I have to think ukuthi kube bekuKristu obezophendula lana, ubezophendula kanjani, because now I've been saved and Christ has been formed in me to a point whereby I live out his character. Because we find when you read in the book of Acts, the way Christians, it was because of how the disciples or the disciples of Jesus were living out this Christianity, and they were called Christians. So that's the right living that we are called into, a righteous living, where you live according to the righteousness of God. You live according to what God has said in his word, because we know very well which yonke into uNkulunkulu adinga ukuthi siyenze, it's in his word. So Second Corinthians chapter number 6, verse number 17, he says, come out from amongst them, touch not the unclean things. So we need to touch not the things that are unclean. So that's a life that God is calling us into as those who are agents of the kingdom. So now Paul, he was speaking about the unbelievers, what they are living like the world, they are living in the standard says. So he said, come out from amongst them. So what gain do you have with unbelievers? So in order for us to embark on this righteous living, we need to come out and touch not the unclean things. Still, we live out the holiness of God. We live out and be able to live according to the righteousness of God. That's the design of God. And then we come to point number 5, then, which is the knowledge of God, the knowledge of the Son of God. John chapter number 17, verse number 3, it says, now this is life eternal, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. So Jesus was speaking there in a form of prayer. So now he's saying this is life eternal, that you may know God, This is life eternal. This is life eternal, that you may know God. So the knowledge of the Son. So we come into the knowledge of the Son. So as people who are agents of the kingdom, we need to have the knowledge of the Son, not just a cognitive, because there is a cognitive knowledge whereby I read, because I read the book of physics, I read biology, I read life sciences, I read chemistry, and I begin to just be conscious and just be a person who is aware, a person who is just cognitive of that understanding. But uNkulunkulu is not just only calling us to that level whereby we just read about him, we know about him. That's a cognitive knowledge of God. And then he needs us to come to experience that knowledge. That is an experience. That is an experience. When you read the book of John, chapter number 1, verse 1, he says, that which we heard and we have handled, we have seen of the word of life, and we have touched. We are speaking that very same word of life unto you. We have heard, we have seen, we have touched. So that's an experience that John was brought into. So that another knowledge of God, whereby we begin to experience God. We begin to experience God and we begin to know him. So even when this has to do with the intimacy, that we have with God, where we know him by experience, not just being cognitive, because that thing of being cognitive, normally it doesn't save, because there are many people who know that Jesus died. There are many people who know that Jesus died for the sins of the world, but they are not saved, which simply means they know him cognitively. So when you meet people, they say, I know God, but they are not saved. So God wants us to come closer to a point that is beyond being cognitive about him. We need to know him by experience. We need to know him to a level whereby we experience him and begin to show forth Ubuti. We are the people who are the agents of the kingdom. We are the people who are the agents of the kingdom. So 2 Peter chapter number 1, verse number 8, as we are coming to closer to the end of this teaching. So 2 Peter chapter number 1, verse number 8. So, for if these things be in you and abound, they make you that ye shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So lapha kuleliya verse likhuluma ukuthi he is speaking about izinto bekade mentiona uPeter lana ukuthi he is speaking about many things, but then he comes ukuthi for if these things be in you and abound, they will make you not to be barren and be unfruitful in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. So that knowledge that he's speaking about the experiential knowledge of God. So as people who are sent out as the agents of the kingdom, we need to know God experientially, so that when we meet the challenges of this world, we will be able to display God. We will be able to show with him this God that we know. We're not just knowing him by ukuthi sifundile ngaye, safunda sazi ngaye, because ukwazi ngaye nokumazi yena are two different things. So we need to know about him and then know him by experience again. So that makes us to be able to influence this world, because this world will respond mostly to a tangible God, will respond mostly to a God who can manifest. So that's one of the parameters of the knowledge of God, which we need to know God. So this gives us to another point, whereby it points us to a prayer and the word, because this knowledge is born by Ubuti. We study the word, we spend time with his word, we know him, we begin to engage and see Ubuti. Laba bahambe phambi kwethu. They wrote about him, so they know him, they have experienced him, and they have shared about what they have experienced in God. So now when we embark and we study the word of God, we will understand, we will be able to engage God, and two, we come to intimacy, which is the ministry of prayer. So now it's the word, it's prayer. So when we are praying, we are engaging God, which then advance our knowledge, because that makes us to be able to experience God, to be able to explore God, because that's one thing that is important for a human being, to explore and experience God through intimacy, which is then made up by the word and prayer. So those things, they make us to journey in the knowledge of God. So by attaining this knowledge, by spending time in the word, spending time in prayer, it makes us to experience God and gain that knowledge of God. So as you read to Revelation chapter number 1, verse number 6, he says, he has made us to be a kingdom and priest to serve his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. So this is one thing. The other version says he has made us kings and priests. So this verse, it suggests to us that we are given a priesthood. So a priesthood, yenzani. We have to go back to into the Old Testament and see ukuthi ngokuka uNkulunkulu aba priests were dealing with offerings, were dealing with sacrifices, were dealing with ama prayers of the people that were serving according to the Levites law. So manje they were serving, but now when we come in as the New Testament saints, we understand very well ukuthi iveil iyadabuka phakathi, so everyone can come boldly into the throne of grace. So the ministry of us being priests and kings, it allows us to engage God by ourselves. Nobody will now come and say, I've stood for you before God. But now we have the opportunity, all of us, when we are born again, we are believers, we have the opportunity to come close to God and be able to explore God and be able to experience God, because that's what God has given unto us freely by faith. So this is one thing the ministry of prayer does. We are priests, we are kings unto God. So this is one thing that is very important to us as people who are sent out. So all these things, asinikeza igunya lokuthi sikwazi ukuthi masifika, because uNkulunkulu he gave us the greatest commandment, Matthew chapter number 28, verse number 19 and 20, which is, go ye into all the world and make disciples and teach them. You see, so that commission, so uNkulunkulu asinikeze yona, is the thing ukuthi sibe ne impact into this world. By understanding these things that we have mentioned, so it makes us to be able to bring out this impact, because these things, they make us to press into God to a point whereby we are able to experience the things uNkulunkulu ezingama promise asinikeze wona in his word, asinikeze wona as ama agents awasende out into the world to make impact. So, and then the last thing, and the last point, it authority and power. When you read Matthew chapter number 28, Luke chapter number 10, verse number 19, just gonna go quickly. Luke chapter number 10 and verse number 19. Lapha uthi uJesu ubanikeza. Okay, Luke chapter number 10, verse number 19. So, Lana, so behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by no means hurt you. So now, because we are not going with one, but siyakwizwe whereby kune creature that took the authority from the first man, we must understand ukuthi we need to be empowered in order for us to be effective enough, because out there, we will face circumstances that are brought by the enemy. So when we are empowered, when we are given power, because Jesus gave one thing, he gave to them, it is power to trade on serpents and scorpions. So they shall no means hurt you. Nothing will hurt you because you are empowered. You are empowered. So Acts chapter 1 verse 8, when the Holy Ghost has come, it shall give you power, so that you shall be my witness in Jerusalem and in all Judea and into all the earth. So lezo zinto, it gives us empowerment. Ukuthi uNkulunkulu is not just sending us into ukuthi sihamba nje asinayo into ethe, but we are with him, we are having his presence in our midst. So that makes us to be empowered. So this empowerment of the Holy Spirit in us, it makes us to be able to manifest God. When you read the book of Exodus, there comes a woman who was demonized, having a demon in her. So when you start the scriptures, the woman started to say, these are the servants of God. They preach the true word of God. But now, Mount we are beggar. We are born with, this is the strange spirit. So what did Paul do? They cast out the devil. They cast out that thing. So, because now, that was a force against their ministry. Because bekungenze ukuthi uzohamba nabo and then kube ukuthi iaffecta a ministry up. So manje when we understand ukuthi the ministry of the Holy Spirit is to make us to be able to give out and be able to dish out izinto zikaNkulunkulu and be able to bring impact into this world. So understand ukuthi umoya ongcwele enye izinto afika nayo, its power for us to be able to be impactful, because we will meet people out there who are sick, who will need this God of ours. Then we will pray for him and we will manifest this God as kingdom agents, because we are sent out in order to manifest God. So, which means now we need to understand ukuthi mangabe uNkulunkulu usethembile ukuthi abantu mabebona thina, they will see him in us. So that's the thing. That's the very important thing about this ministry esinikeziwe as believers. So as people who are ambassadors of the kingdom, as people who are sent out to represent God. Remember we said agents are those who are standing for somebody. It's somebody who can stand instead of the other. So we are standing for God on this planet Earth. So we need to understand these parameters and be able to explore God so that impilo yethu ingezukusenza sibe irrelevant in this world, because for us to be relevant, we need to explore God and bring influence kaNkulunkulu. It's not by might, it's not by ukwenza kwethu, but it's us engaging lezinto kuNkulunkulu, because we understand ukuthi when the Holy Spirit came upon us, ufike nezipho, ufike nezinto eziningi in us. So he gave us confidence, he gave us a confidence only in him and in his word, so that we go out and preach the word. When we preach the word, when we go out, we have to understand ukuthi la sibekwe khona asibekelwanga to fulfill our selfish desires, but we are placed in order for us to fulfill imind zikaNkulunkulu, because God needs men to impact this world. Kuma spaces, kuma industries esikuwo, in our work, in our businesses, wherever we are, we must go with the consciousness ukuthi singama ambassadors. We must go with the consciousness ukuthi asibona nje abantu abazile nje ukuthi sihole and be able to live impilo efancy nempilo emnandi, but singabantu abathunyiwe to make God known, because izwe alimazi uNkulunkulu. So ukuze bezwe kumele bezwe, lithi ku Romans chapter number 10 verse number 14, lithi lenkosi, how shall they hear without anyone preaching to them? So there must be somebody who is preaching to them. So all these things, they are making us to fulfill this great commandment, which we're going out to preach the word, we are going out to make disciples. So when we go out, because wherever we gather in our churches, that those are training centers where believers are trained, where ambassadors of God are trained, where agents of the kingdom are trained in order for them to go out and be able to dish out God. So when they see us, they must see God. Actually, we are the address of God. So we are the address that might point people to God. So abantu, when they look us, kumele babone uNkulunkulu. So that's the summary when we're looking at these parameters. This is what I mentioned. Bazalwane egameni likaKristu Jesu. So this is the things that uNkulunkulu has nikeze zona for this, under this topic. There are many things that we could have discussed, but because we cannot explore all of them because of time, but I believe God will help us with something as we embark on this, as we look upon this. Ngegama lenkosi uKristu Jesu. My brother, Unxeu, I don't know, let me give it unto you, and or maybe pray before. Yeah, let us, we're just going to pray over this so that it's not just going to be a thing that is normal, but it's just going to be something that will change us, that will make us to that will make the image of Christ to be formed in us, because that the grace is the thing that is needed for us to be impactful in this world. So the image of Christ must be formed in us. So let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We have shared your heart. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my father, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, for this platform that you have given my brother, in the name of Jesus Christ. We are called to be advancers of your kingdom, to be people who are going to advance your kingdom in this nation of South Africa, in this nation of Africa, in this whole world, uNkulunkulu. Sisithunyele ukuba sizo-advance umbuso wakho. Ngakho uNkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, we pray that you empower us. We pray, uNkulunkulu, that you stand with us. We pray that you transform us. We pray, uNkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, as you have spoken, Lord, we pray ukuba wenze umehluko in our lives. We pray, uNkulunkulu, egameni likaKristu Jesu waseNazaretha, that you begin to transform us, uNkulunkulu wethu ongcwele, and let Christ be formed in us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we trust you for transformation. We trust you for a change in our lives. We thank you, Father, and we give you the praise and honor in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you, sir. Amen.
Bafowethu, ayikho into enginikeza intokozo njengokubona abantu abasha, abantu abasebancane benentshisekelo engaka loNkulunkulu nokushumayela ivangeli. Angazi noma abazalwane niyayizwa yini weight yale message, and look at the guy ukuthi how young he is, but ukhuluma into eqinile, because besidla isitambu namhlanje, ukudla sikudlayo, besidla isitambu, besidla ukudla kwangempela, besidla ukudla esikudingayo. You know, ukhulume ngamapoint abaluleke kakhulu la uNyambose. Mina of God, siyambonga uNkulunkulu, praise my God. Increase you, my God, increase you mfowethu. Uqhubeke nje ube content in Jesus Christ. Yeah, he shared six parameters of kingdom agents. Number one is faith. Number two, it was kingdom mindset. Number three, kingdom ambassadors. Righteous living, knowledge of God, and authority and power. Zonke lezinto izinto ezibalekile bazalwana. We are kingdom ambassadors. Sina la emhlabeni kune-purpose uNkulunkulu asilethela yona. Purpose yakhe ukuthi we are here to colonize the earth. We are here to colonize the world with the kingdom culture. So, number one, into iqala kwi-faith ekukholweni. Indaba nje iqala lapho. Kunevesi esilithatha kancane, lela vesi leliya liyayenza idamage, because silithatha kancane leli vesi elilapha romance yathi khona ukukholwa kubayo ukholwa ngenhliziyo ivuma ngomlomo ubukwamtshela uJesu. You know, we take it so lightly ngale ndlela yokuthi ma uzwe kahle unjabule ekhuluma lapha nge knowledge of God. There are people who know God, but there are people, it doesn't mean ukuthi they have a relationship with God. They just know God as an information ukuthi okay, God uyena, like abantu abazi ukuthi umveli nqandi wadala, siyazi ukuthi okay, umhlaba wadala uNkulunkulu abantu nakho konke okukhona na mhlaba kwadala uNkulunkulu. That's a knowledge, that's an information they have about God, but they don't have a relationship with God. So there are people who take lela verse light ngale ndlela yokuthi but hayi ngoba vele ngiyakhole ukuthi umhlaba ukhona, hayi shuthi nami ngiyamvuma uJesu, kube kuphela kanjalo. This thing goes deep. Lento le yokukholwa bafethu iqhamuka nomoya ongcwele. Into edala umuntu ukuthi akholwe umoya ongcwele, because he is the one who comes with a conviction in the heart. Lokho okukonfess uvume, okokwenza okwesigxivizo to be sure, but the person ukuthi umuntu aconvert is the Holy Spirit. Because uzathi akazi iziphole osho ukuthi ivangeli libula kwababhubhane, but it is power to us because we have a revelation. But this revelation, you only have this revelation if you have the relationship with God, because having the relationship with God is the meaning of life. If you want to know what life is, life is more than existence or significance of an existence. But the main purpose of life was for mankind to have a relationship with God. So that is life. Because we serve a living God. The reason why he is a living God is because he is life. In him there is life. So then they have faith, prophets. It's very, very important. I'm telling the prophet Simanga, because uyayishumela indaba yeyifaith, and mayishumela uyishumela even umzalwane kuyambuleka la ayazi indaba, usazi isitori sakhe noGod. And then he spoke about, I think it was the second parameter, like he spoke about a kingdom mind first. Uthi Paul masiguqule iy'ngqondo zethu, aphinde athi aphinde athi mawubekini lo mqondo woKristu Jesu, lo mqondo woKristu Jesu mawubekini. So that transformation of the mind is very, very important, because whatever that we do, we think, we say must be on the perspective of God. So we must do things on the perspective of Christ. So we need to change our mindsets. We need to change the level of thinking. The way of thinking must change. And we think like Jesus Christ. And then he shared about third kingdom ambassador. Prophet, we are here. Njengoba sila emhlabeni asibona balo mhlaba, thina sizithunywa, sizigqila zevangeli. We are here to preach the word. We are here to simele a kingdom. And for the kingdom, the king is Jesus Christ. Our king is Jesus Christ. A kingdom is a country. A kingdom is a place where the ruler or the president is the king. And in this kingdom, our king is Jesus Christ. So we are here to colonize this world with the kingdom culture. So we are kingdom ambassadors. So an ambassador, ayenze ukuthanda kwakho. Ewayishare imessage emnandi injabulo. Ambassador akuyena umuntu ozokwenza intando yakhe. Because bazalwane, even you know, even loving God, we don't love God in our way. We love God in his way. We love God in his way. And in a call of ngalona lo thande simthanda ngalo, akulona uthando lwethu. Uzabhala uPeter lapha uthi he even deposits the love in our heart to love him. Number one, asimthandi ngothando lwethu. Uthando vela sinike yona lwena alidiposite enhlizweni zethu. Number two, asimthandi ngendlela yethu. Angathi if you learn about relationships, there's this thing called i-love language. I-love language, umuntu wesilisa, you need to love umuntu wesifazane ngale ndlela yena afuna ukuthandwa ngayo, hayi ngendlela wena othanda ngayo. Same thing applies. Lento vele ya-adopt-a lapha kuNkulunkulu. UNkulunkulu asimthandi ngendlela yethu. If we love God, asisho ngomlomo but kubonakala izenzo. Ngakho uJesu wethini, laba ababafowethu laba benza intando kababa. And if we love God, we love his people, because God loves his people. For God so loved the world, he gave away his begotten son. Because why? Love is a foundation of his salvation. He sacrificed, he gave his begotten son because he loved us. So as kingdom ambassadors, we need to put it in mind. Ukuthi asenze intando yethu la, senze intando ko yalosithumile, senze intando kababa. Righteous living, our character, thina sibonakala ngecharacter. And lento yokulunga bafowethu ayiwona amandla akho. This is a free gift. Ngesikhathi usindiswa, that is sindiswa samkela uKristu, futhi wasesilungile. Imagine unxewu. For people who know my past, the Holy Spirit only helped me. Ngokukholwa into esebhayibhelini ukuthi uJesu wafa wavuka and wayefela izono zami. Thenga isikhathi esevuka wavuka kanye nako. Leyo nto leyo, it's very difficult ukuthi uyibelieve. But because of the Holy Spirit, it gave me faith ukuthi le nto ngiyikholwe. Ngasithi, so people who know my past, manje sekuzothiwa ngingolungileyo. I never did nothing. I think it's in the book of Zechariah, chapter number 4, verse 6. Not by power, nor by might, but by the Spirit of the living God. Young people, I want a man. We are being called righteous people. It's a gift, as I told a man. Even holiness, it's a gift. We are called holy because he is holy. He instructs us to be holy as he is holy. So we are righteous. It's a gift that we were given. Because God is the right God. Knowledge of God. Not just ukwazi ukuthi there is a God out there. But ukudlula ekwazini kwakhe, ukumazi. Sina ukuthi we you know njabulo kwethu on the Old Testament, the prophets, they used to operate it was like an event where you speak and let us cut ends a little miracle. Now we have an intimate relationship with him. The prophet in the Old Testament, Babenzenjan, but umuntu mezo and the miracle no mezo ezo Jesus prophet Google up each and every prophet, especially if you read in what Ezekiel. Ezekiel, before he prophesied, all the chapters, you must read all the book. But the umoya kaNkulunkulu ongaphezu kwami, noma isandla sikaNkulunkulu sasingaphezu kwami. Thina ke, he lives in us. We have an intimate relationship with him. So as we know him deep, and the Holy Spirit is the wisdom of God who grant us to be, who grant us an access to become revealers. Just imagine. He grants us the access to become revealers. My God, we don't just know God because he's a creator. We know more. He even reveals us the mysteries of God. Just imagine, he gives us the mystery. That's how deep we know God. And we grow in knowing God. You will never grow in knowing God if you never receive Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. This message and namhlanje is very, very powerful. And the last one, authority and power. Bazalwane, we need to understand Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. UNkulunkulu lapha, he gave us power, he gave us dominion. Uthi, listen to this. When he was creating, uthi, masenze, there's a singular and a plural. Masenze, it's a plural statement. So there was a meeting. It's God, it's the Son, and it's the Holy Spirit. They're having a meeting. They are discussing what we need to create. But masenze umuntu ngomfanekiso wethu asifuze. And then masuthi lapho uwehla njalo, they are excluding themselves now. Sebethini maba uwenze njalo umhlaba, bawudominate, bawudle umhlaba, bawudominate. Akasho ke manje ukuthi asu dominate. God now is excluding himself. So we are giving power, we are giving authority over everything. When God created, he said, let us make man. So God was involved with the happiness of the heavens, of the kingdom. But when God is giving us the world, the earth, who says he? Let them have dominion. Yes, so let them have dominion. Yeah, but God is excluding himself. Meaning, whatever ela emhlabeni sinamandla ngaphezukwayo, sinegunya ngaphezukwayo. Ingakho even lento yamademon, we don't interview amademon. You don't interview amademon. Once you interview a demon, usuqonda ukuthi we level eyodwa naye.
Yes. Bafoni.
I'm fired up. I'm revived. This guy was spitting nugget of kingdom. You know, this guy was speaking the heart of God. Man of God, no, thank you very much. Thank you very much, man. Thank you very much. What a message. What a message. Before we close, mhlambe singathi put mampethu sithi buka ama comments laphana singayivali sishiya abantu abangaphandle lapha because people are here in the comments. Laba ababingelelayo, I'm just gonna read kulaba nje who are saying something. We are here. Unqobile lapha representative aphinda azothi we are here on behalf of the kingdom of God. Yes, we are here to colonize earth, bazalwane, with the kingdom culture. And then aphinda azothi lapha, so this means everything we do is for the benefits of the kingdom of God. Yabona ke ubambe ngakho impela ke Nqobile aphinda athi laphana, even our earthly qualifications must serve in the kingdom. Hey, ubambile unqo uyizwa kabili le message athi lapha uDoli Cukulu ukuthi sizithunya, lokho kusho ukuthi asifike senze ngendlela yethu la sithunye khona, and we don't adopt izinto zakhona, senza esikuthunyiwe awuNkulunkulu. Hey madod, ngaze ngamthanda namhlanje bazalwane. Aphinde athi lapha uDoli, awufiki wenze okwakho noma okwakhona, wenza okuthunyiwe. Jesu uthi ngenza intando yongithumileyo. Aphinde athi ngenza intando kababa. Hey my God, yabona ke manje usuku, yabona lapha kwi parameter lesi 5, let knowing God, usumazi kwenye level lapha uNkulunkulu uma usumbiza ngubaba. Usune revelation. You know bazalana ukuthi kunama revelations, kunama mysteries. Once wafika la khona usumbulewa khona, usumbulelwa khona, and not ama revelations but ama mysteries. Usu graduated to be a son. You are no longer a child of God, but you are a son of God. We spoke about the sonship in this show. So an ambassador takes order from the one from the one superior to him or her always. We need to take orders only from God because he is the ruler of his kingdom. Everything we do is for benefit of his kingdom, which is why who we are by birth is to die in order to take on who Christ is. When you are an agent, nezembatho zakho kuba izembatho ezine logo yekampani or izwe olimele. The question is, have we truly put on the full armor of the one we represent? Yo, no, this one is very, very powerful. It's touching. Utudoli lapha, the package was perfect for this day. Siyabonga. No man, nami ngisho njalo impela. Umbuso Jill Ukhele, siyabonga njabulo. We thank God for your life, mfowethu. Sibonga mfoka Ukhele. Ningene nini nibangaki? Yeke lento yokuinterview amadimoni bazalwane. Bafowethu, we thank you very much, man of God. Yambose, siyabonga man of God. UNkulunkulu akukhulise mfowethu. May God increase you, may God enlarge your territory. May you always be content in Jesus Christ, preaching the word of God. Hey, yasweka le nceku bafowethu. Maningakaze nibone, hey yaswenka lenceku le ayekho inceku eswenka njengale nceku. Khona le nceku kajola ukuhamba nayo uculu, yamazeka uculu lapha emkhohlwe igama lakhe uculu ngaze sibonge lapha ku-TikTok nowechwechwa, i-king of chwechwa. Ayi nale nceku azichwechi kanje, abaswenki kanje, kodwa-ke futhi siyezwa nasolimini ukuthi no, le nceku le zi-content uJesu. Bazalwane, siyambonga kakhulu uNkulunkulu. Man of God, just unmute yourself lapho uvalelise sesivala inkonzo.
Uh, Hallelujah. Futhi asibonge mfowethu uDumo ngoba kuNkulunkulu, and we thank God for this platform, and yeah, we believe uNkulunkulu will transform the lives of people, and also he will still continue to do so, and we believe God is going to grow this platform ekuthenini advance izindaba zombuso kaNkulunkulu. So mfowethu, I pray also the prayers that you have prayed for me, that you come to the right and advance everything that you do, bring what we call destiny helpers who will come and save you with all the materials that you need, if it's everything, man. And yeah, and we believe God is going to do so much. Saving him, it's truly an honor. We thank him for this platform in the net. Siyabonga mfowethu. Sibonge nakubazalwane who came and be with us who live, and yeah, siyathoka kakhulu uDumo lobe kuNkulunkulu. Amen. Sibonge mfowethu.
No, I said with us and watch this powerful message that I'm trying. Same time, same with your boy, your brother, and it's where we preach and teach the word of God. It's all about Jesus Christ and him alone. Him crucified. Your number one online Christian show.